Double Dragon 5, The Shadow Falls is a fighting game released in 1994 for the Genesis and Super Nintendo and later ported to the Atari Jaguar. This was a licensed game, and the original developer, Technos Japan, had little to nothing to do with this game. It is based on the animated series.
Double Dragon! It's double the kick, double the edge, and double the fun. Saving Metro City from the evil of the Shadow Master and his ruthless crew of Shadow Warriors. Fighting for right with the might of the dragon. Hey, like the code of the dragon says, you gotta be there. By the power of the dragon!
Saturday at 8:30 on UPN 50.
Which I never saw as a kid, and boy, I can see I wasn't missing much. This game is pretty ugly. The backgrounds look okay, but the character sprites are horrendous. Just fucking awful. Reminds me of the awful Time Killers port on the Sega Genesis. The music is once again pretty boring. Sound effects too. Really, I can't say it enough, the overall presentation here is just terrible. I guess it's good that this game returns to the post-apocalyptic universe of the first few games, but really, the levels are boring and not really much stands out here. The two good guys here are the Lee brothers, with the game stating that Jimmy Lee has just rejoined his brother after a run as the right-hand man of the Shadow Lord. This means the various evil characters here are fighting for the newly opened position at his side. The evil roster consists of Jawbreaker, a mutant with a large jaw and voracious appetite. Ice Pick, the Sub-Zero ripoff of the bunch who is said to be a hacker. Bones is an undead warrior armed with a laser gun. Sickle is a street thug armed with, well, a sickle. Blade is a mercenary who's been hired to off the Lee brothers. Trigger Happy is what would happen if Mega Man and Duke Nukem had a kid. Countdown is a cyborg with various weapons installed to thwart attacks. And Sekka is another mercenary with armor similar to Blade. All in all, none of these characters play well, and none are truly memorable. They all pretty much have movesets reminiscent of Street Fighter 2, and honestly, that's what this game is trying to be. Trying, but failing. The characters are stiff. The move's tired, the fight's uninteresting. I couldn't even play this one long before I just didn't want to play anymore. It really offers nothing to a player that couldn't be found better elsewhere. Even die-hard fans of Double Dragon and his cartoon would be hard-pressed to find anything interesting here. I'd rather play Super Double Dragon than this mess. Just another one in the wave of Street Fighter 2 ripoffs prevalent at the time because publishers just wanted to make a dollar off of an established franchise and an established genre of game, I guess I could say, in the fighting game genre that was blossoming at the time with games such as Mortal Kombat and Street Fighter 2, especially. Avoid this game at all costs. There's a far better Double Dragon fighting game out there coming up later on our channel.